Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're gonna look at the Cedar Creek Silverback Edition 29RE. So an overview on this particular coach is this is going to have one of the biggest living room areas in the back that you'll be able to find, because they are both very large slide outs that are opposing from each other, so it's like a ballroom inside there. Also with the Silverback, you're looking at a very high insulated coach, so that means you're going to stay cooler in the summer times, warmer in the winter times, fully enclosed underbelly. This also has one of the nicest units for construction as well. Cedar Creek is known for their construction. They build everything so that it'll last twice as long as just about anybody else out there. They're also the number one customer satisfaction rating out of all coaches with any kind of significant numbers for larger manufacturers. One of the first things I want to show you out here is the new set of stairs that they have. So you'll notice this is a little bit wider door than most coaches out there. They have the nice storm flap here, so if it's really windy outside, all that cold air isn't going in here, even if you just have the screen door. And the other cool thing, lock that in place, is the new set of stairs that they have. So there's just a little deal right here, and then these are aluminum, so they're super lightweight, easy to work with, and they're a lot sturdier than the kinds that have to hang in the air, and then a lot of times that gets bent over time. You also have the large grab assist handle, which is super nice. And while we're here, I'll show you that this has the nice tires on it, and they have the nitrogen fill tires, so they run at a lot cooler rate. They're more resistant to breaking down over time, so the air doesn't escape. They handle better, they brake better, and then there are also the aluminum rims. Over here, you'll notice it has a very large pass-through storage. This is the aluminum, and if you look on the back sides of these, you'll see that there's those L brackets that I was telling you about. You'll notice that they also fully glue the studs down on the wood here, and then that this is plywood instead of OSB chipboard. Now, a lot of guys, they'll put like a piece of carpet here to hide the fact that it's OSB. So if you see that, you can kind of feel the roughness of it, and that'll tell you if it's OSB or normal plywood. The benefit of plywood is if you get some water, let's say overflow from the toilet or the shower, or you break a line, which all those things can happen, then the water isn't going to ruin that OSB chipboard. This is a much better way to do that. This is also metal latches for your slam latches instead of plastic, so this is going to last a lot longer as well. Outside speakers here, you also have a 110 outlet, so if you wanted to put a TV out here, you can. This has the LED lights all the way across, power awning, and so all you have to do is push a button for that awning to go in and out. I'll also show you that on top of this awning, there is a metal cover, so when you put this awning in all the way, it has a protection on it so that that fabric doesn't get little pinholes and cracking where the last foot of that awning sticks out. Here on the front cap, this is a fiberglass gel coat front cap. It has the nice LEDs across the front to be able to make your coach look really nice as you're going down the road, but it also provides some light right in the area of your hitch. So when you're plugging into it in the dark, you're able to see what you're doing. And you'll notice these corners are cut in a little bit. So if you have a short bed, 6.5 foot bed or 6 foot bed truck, you're not going to have to slide your slider hitch back as often because of this. As we go over here, one push button auto level system that is super easy to use. You just push the button auto level. You can also adjust the hitch height. You can retract all from this side as well as from the inside. I also wanted to point out that the dry weight of this coach is 10 8,645 pounds. Now that's not including all the stuff that you might put in there. So you're gonna put in some water, all your camping gear, things like that. Over here, you have a full docking station as well as easy reel. So this is where your 50 amp cord is. Now you can imagine this guy is pretty heavy. And so to have this not strung out all over the place is really nice with this easy reel. You also have a battery disconnect here. This cuts off all the power to the coach. There's a few things that draw the battery down as time goes on, especially in storage. So to be able to disconnect that and not have to worry about, did I leave a light on, is nice. Hot and cold water ran to this guy, and this is a high pressure washer shower. So if you needed to rinse something off, you have that ability. You also have full control over your hydraulic slides. Now this is not the main case usually. Usually if you have hydraulic slides, that means you have to push all the slides out or all the slides in, because you don't get to control which one goes in and out. With these knobs right here, you can control that. So if you're pulled off to the side of the highway and you just want one side of your coach to go out, you can do that. This also has all the connections to be able to bypass your hot water heater and also winterize your coach. So this hose right here pulls out and you can winterize your coach very easily. All your gate valves for your dump valves are in here as well. And what that allows you to do is not have to worry about them freezing up because they're exposed to the elements. You also have bedroom and living room satellite cable hookups here. Black tank sewer flush, city and freshwater fill. And then this guy is a 10 gallon hot water heater that will refresh up to 16.2 gallons of water per hour. And then this is the 50 amp connection right here. Back here, you'll notice that you have a ladder to be able to get to the top of your roof if you want, as well as a nice bumper that has the diamond plate over it. You also have a backup camera, not just backup camera ready, but it actually comes with a backup camera. And then you also get a little LCD screen that you can plug into your truck, right into the cigarette lighter, and then put it right on the dash. That way when you're backing up, you can see what you're doing. Let's go take a look on the inside. As we're going inside, you'll notice there is a little peephole here to be able to see what's going on before you open your door. Come on in. So this is the coach. As you can see, it's very open inside here. There's lots of room. And I love that they even put the gabled slide out over on this side too. It gives you not only more headroom, but it just makes the room feel a lot bigger. Also on the outside on this particular slide out, everything's gonna slide right off to, you know, if you had like a pine cone that landed on top of there. So that's one less thing to worry about. Back here, you'll notice there's a very large TV. Also, you have the electric fireplace, lots of cabinetry, LED lights underneath. These are controllable by just a push of a button, as well as you can control them on the sides for the lights inside the cabinets as well. Also, you'll notice this has no air conditioner right here. That's because the air conditioner is actually on top of the roof. This is the quietest air conditioner system that you will find in an RV. You'll notice that the return vents are on the sides over here. What that does is, instead of having that return vent right in the middle and all the air blowing right out, it cuts down the noise in about a half to a third of what it would normally be. You also notice that the ceiling is barreled. And again, just to give you a much bigger feel in here, as well as having things roll off the edges instead of having standing water on top of your roof, which is obviously not a great idea. Cedar Creek uses only the highest grade chairs. You'll notice that they use Lazy Boys exclusively. Nobody else in the industry does that. A few things that are kind of nice about these guys. One, it has, if you listen to it, that click noise is an exclusive thing just for Lazy Boy. That means you can put your feet up at this level or this level. Nobody else can do that. Another thing that you'll notice with Lazy Boys is, if you look underneath here, this has a piece of wood right there. All the other chairs out there will not have that. So it makes it so that the chair becomes unstable over the years. This is also the only type of chair that, if you wanted to just lean back without your feet going up, you can do that. Other chairs won't allow you to do that. So yeah, there's a few advantages for sure to going to Lazy Boy. Wanted to show you the other seating area over here. This is the couch. The way this guy works is it is a sofa sleeper, so this guy pulls out if you want it to. Over here in the kitchen area, you'll notice that this is a electric refrigerator that is much bigger than your typical RV refrigerator. It has the ice maker built into it, and you have twice as much room as a normal refrigerator for RVs. The reason why they can get away with that is because they have a 1,000-watt inverter built into it just for the refrigerator. That means you can run the camper off of 110 and still have your fridge going, or just off the batteries, and that 1,000-watt inverter will transfer the electricity from battery power over to 110, which is what this is needing. Also, if you ever have to replace your refrigerator, it's about half the cost compared to a RV refrigerator that's gas and 110. Over here, you'll notice there's the large 22-inch oven in here. And then you'll notice this is a little bit nicer too than your typical RV. It's a little bit thicker type of material for the burners, 3-burner stove. And this guy does fold down to give you extra counter space. It is the solid surface counter space. You also have a 110 outlet over here. Extra large microwave. This is not your typical half size microwave. Over here, stainless steel sink in here. We also have a spot for the trash can. You could probably even fit two in there if you wanted to. And then these are the soft closed drawers. They even give you a spot, and this is Velcroed in here, by the way, so that when you close that last inch, it closes on its own. That's a benefit as you're running down the road and your drawers aren't coming open all the time. Again, lots of cabinet space above here. You also have some crown molding, so if you wanted to store something that you don't get to very often up there, you can do that. And then up above us, we have a high-powered Creator Breeze Fantastic Fan. That guy can pull in as much as 920 cubic feet of air per minute. It does have the rain sensor on it, so that if it starts raining, it'll automatically close for you instead of soaking this entire area. And you can open up a window, that means, turn that fan on, and that'll create up to a 10-mile-per-hour breeze through your camper without having to run your air conditioner. To be able to control that Fantastic Fan, you'll notice you have a little control box right here. You can control that by temperature as well as just overall speed. You can make it go up and down. And then this is for your dual zone air conditioner as well as your furnace. So you can control all that from the same unit. Now this does have two air conditioners on it, one in the living room, one in the bedroom, and then they have separate sensors to be able to sense the temperature in here versus the bedroom. As we come around to down here, I'll show you that this does have central vac built into it. So it does come with a hose that connects right into here, and that you can stretch all the way from one end to the coach over to the other. This is your command center over here. This will tell you how full your batteries are, how full your tanks are for your freshwater, black water, gray tanks, your water pump. This also has heated holding tanks. And that's what this button is. That is basically heat pads on the bottoms of your tanks so that you are protected from freezing. Those automatically turn on at about 43 degrees and then keep you going, and then it'll automatically turn it off if it's above that. Water heater, awning controls, awning lights, slide out rooms, all that is controlled here. And then this is cool too. This is a new thing that they've just recently added. This is kind of nice because what it does is it can tell you, you know, not only do you have control over your 6-point leveling system in here, you also have some how-to. So if you forgot how your hot water heater works, or how the bypass valves were supposed to be, or how to slide your slides in, or troubleshooting your coach and you're out in the middle of nowhere, this is kind of nice because it has all that built into it. So you can watch a little video on how to do that, and it just stays right here. There's frequently asked questions. And then right below here is your solar power connection. So if you decide to add a solar panel down the road, this makes the labor cost about half as much because all the wires are ran, as opposed to having to fish that through the ceiling, which you can imagine takes some time. And then this right here is the other half of your backup camera. Let me show you what that looks like. So this, you basically put this in your truck, connect this on, plug this guy into your cigarette lighter, and then this wirelessly connects to your backup camera. That way you can see what's going on. Let's show you some stuff in the upstairs area now. So as you come upstairs, one thing I'll point out is it does have the King Jack antenna. This is cool because it's more of a dish instead of a giant arm that comes up and down. This is getting away with not having to worry about remembering to put that antenna down and then traveling with it down the road in the wind, taking it off, and hopefully not doing thousands of dollars of damage to your rubber roof. As we head into the bathroom, you'll notice they finished off the cabinetry and the sink area in the same type of material that they did the kitchen area, so it ties it all together a little bit nicer. You do have a nice size medicine cabinet here. Nice LED lights to be able to see everything. Porcelain commode instead of a plastic one, so a nice upgrade there, as well as a linen closet over here, and a second high-powered Creator Breeze fan built into the coach. As you see, there's plenty of room in the shower here. There's a spot to sit down if you need to. Little shelves to work with, skylight above me. And then you'll notice all these vents not only open and close, but you can move them side to side. What that's nice is it'll be able to make it so that you can cool off the areas where you want to cool off more and not waste all the cold air that's going through your coach. Let's go into the bedroom. And this is the bedroom. First thing you'll notice is this is a nice size king size, residential king size mattress. So this isn't just an RV size mattress. This is a 70 by 80 mattress. They also put the nice little shades on the sides, and they're the slow rise shades. You can adjust those to the correct height if you want. And then you have a little shelf to be able to put like your cell phone or whatever. And you do have a plug-in to be able to plug in like, you know, your cell phone or whatever. Again, some manufacturers, if they are doing the Whisper Quiet air conditioner, they don't do it in the bedroom, which is unfortunate, but these guys are doing that. So Whisper Quiet air conditioning in here, and you'll notice I still have plenty of height to work with, to be able to not knock my head around as I'm walking through here. Inside the closet here, you'll notice there's lots of shelves, which is kind of unique for a camper to have shelves inside the closet, as well as over here, there's more drawers on top of the ones that are in the bedroom themselves. So if I showed you these are a little bit deeper ones. And again, they did the nice slow close drawers in here. And then a laundry hamper, lots of spots to work with, large mirrors, so you are set to go. So that's the Silverback Cedar Creek 29RE. Please check out our website. It's thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. If you like our videos and you want to see more, go ahead and hit the subscribe button, and that will show you a video each one we make. We try to make a couple, at least a few every week, to show you what's coming into our dealership. And we'll also try to do some tips and tricks type of videos here shortly as well. Also, let me know what you think about our 360 videos. We're trying something new to see what people think about those. Our phone number is 970-313-4337. If you have any questions, you can email us at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or you can give us a call. You can even talk to me or any of our sales staff. We are very knowledgeable. We highly value education and learning about these products so that we can teach you guys about it and trying to find out what the best bang for your buck is. So thanks, guys. Have a great day.